Hello everyone and welcome back to round two of season three at GRM. It is our second game of the season. The Invaders back in action against the Wasps. You can see the screen has the two teams on it. They've just disappeared. But here's the matchup for today. Season three just getting underway. We are looking for our first win of the season. So we're going to flick around to a bit of a side-on view here before we kick the game off. We're going to zoom out. And we're going to look to get today's matchup underway. Of course, it is the Invaders on the right-hand side of your screen playing in the yellow, black, and red. And it is the Galway Wasps playing in the blue and white. So, let's not bugger around anymore. Let's get today's game underway. And it is the Invaders who are receiving and not taking the kickoff straight off the whistle. So, underway we go very quickly in this match, which really is a must-win after that terribly painful loss in round number one. We're looking for revenge. We're going to come back and storm our way back into the season. So it is on early defensive duty straight away. The team unchanged for today's game as well. Not much is really happening in the club at the moment. Scouting a few youth players, keeping an eye on that transfer market, which has been pretty tasty. If you're playing the game, you'll know that there's a lot of young superstars around, but it is the Wasps who are making early room. I'm not even going to try and say that guy's name because that was just ridiculous. We've turned the ball over. This is good. Bondesio kicks it away. That's what I like. That is game plan. And we put the pressure straight back on them as the fullback looks to play a little bit of fancy work. They've made a little bit of room down the left-hand side, but we're shutting them down good, and the game plan is key. So we've turned it over again. I like it. Big run there for Evans. He's been squashed like a little bug and he's lost the ball. Well done. So I didn't think anything's going to happen too early on. We don't have a fullback, which is a bit of a concern, but this one will run in the end goal and dived on. Technically, will be a 22 dropout. No worries. So nothing happening at the moment. We're a couple of minutes into the game. We'll see when the action will start. We can see the Wasps have started to pull out their game plan, which is very similar to ours. Muhammad, average kick. Alright, so it's good news at the moment for us. We've forced the knock on, which means it's a scrum feed for the Invaders. Hanano looking for a backline move here. Bondesio creates an overlap of Muhammad in the line. Muhammad away to Carter. Carter, oh, what a pass! Muhammad in space, and the fullback comes screaming in from the back and creates an overlap. Doubles round to score a brilliant try for the Invaders. That is beautiful work. And we seen last week, Bondesio. What a kick. What a kick, son. That is amazing. We are on the board at 7-0, but we cannot hesitate on this lead because we've seen, well, this is a good run for Mayo. Lost it. Intercepted, but it's been knocked on by, hopefully, the Wasps. Yes, we're going to come all the way back. So we seen last week in round one. Wow, our scrum is getting decimated. And I don't quite know. Well, that's a penalty to the Wasps. That's not good. That is not good at all. They're having a shot at goal, which has gone astray. Oh, no, that is a terrible knock-on. Muhammad has had an absolute nightmare in the end goal. Now a five-meter scrum, and I think they've given away the advantage as well. Oh, what a terrible play from the Wasps. That was dreadful. They're going for touch after taking a shot at goal just before. Question marks about this. Oh, we've turned the line out over about these tactics. Good kick away, Lior. That is beautiful work. So we're put under the pump. A big tester. And we've come out of it on the right side. Turn over a line out as well. I like to see it. So like I was saying about a half an hour ago, last week we were up 14-0. Oh, he skipped through. What a run through there from Maldonado. So funny name, strange name. But we gave away a big lead. We don't want to do that today. It's advantage for offside again for the Wasps. And we'll be going back for another penalty. And they're going for the corner again. Wow. They are putting on the pressure here. There's no question about that. Line out. 12 minutes gone. It's gone to the back. Walsh looking to a big tackle. A big attempt to tackle there by someone in the Invaders shirt. Don't know who that was. Now, Again, going for a little chip over the top. It's gone over the sticks, but it's claimed at the back. Muhammad, give that man a round of applause. He caught the ball. So 22 dropout, cleared our lines. Defensively, that has worked a charm. We can go forward now and see when the next exciting piece of play will be. But hold on. We've turned this ball over here. Waiting for it, there's Hanano. Goes to Mayo. Waited by third. Quick hands. And just about. Still sits here for Hanano. He's directing his troops round. Look at the depth of this back line to the right. But Brock has done the good thing. He's kicked it. And it's well taken at the back too. That is a dreadful. That is a terrible bomb. It's gone straight up. But he's pulled in. Knocked it on. Go. Run. O'Neill Brown. Sips it back inside. Bullseye. Advantage for the knock on. Still with the Invaders. I was going to skip forward here to see when the next highlight would be. But it seems to be this game is full of highlights at the moment. O'Neill Brown, we're going back for the knock-on. Scrum feed Invaders. Now, last time we had a scrum feed, we set-pieced it, and we've turned it over. Wow. Well done, forward pack. You're getting smashed as well. So they'll clear their line, and now we can see what happens next. Good kick, Muhammad. Oh, yes! We've done very well there. Their fullback made a scything run through our defensive line. And we've shut him down. We've got a penalty. I presume he didn't release the ball in the tackle. So we've done well there. And we've earned ourselves a penalty with a now line out. And now we've got a set piece play. Wide ball. Quick hands. Almost. Muhammad. If he could have gone to O'Neill Brown, we would have been in with a grin. But it's quickly recycled. Oh, Patricio. Away to O'Neill Brown. Who is in for try number two. And the Invaders have two tries to zip after 18 minutes. Brock Bondicio. What have you got for a son? That looks a bit wayward. It's not coming back. And it will stay wide. 12-0 the score. The Invaders looking the better of the two teams at the moment. But, like we saw last week, oh, that is a terrible take. Carter getting smashed straight away. We've given away the ball as well. Not a good turnaround after scoring. You don't want to concede straight away. Another kick. They are doing these little attacking kicks far too often. Muni Muni Valu all over that. He's going to be forced in goal, is he? No. Somehow we keep it out. Kick it away, Brock. Good work. Bondicio is on fire today. That is an extremely good kick from Bondicio. So it's a line out here for the Wasps. They've got a little bit of a flat back line there. They're really, really flat. Now they start to give themselves a bit of depth. It is 4-on-3. Little turnaround ball over that numbers here. It's straight through the middle. And it's Will Marwa, who just about gets away. Good save, though, defensively. We're looking all right. We've been pretty good so far today. Short pass. Oh, away! And Miranda will score. He just gets away the tackle of Carter. And that is good speed from the open side flanker. He created that space. It's 12-5. And now it's well and truly game on. Here is Walsh from the sideline. That is some kick from the scrum half as well. Underway we go again. Invaders kicking back off. And it is 12-7 now. Well and truly game on. That missed kick from Bondicio. Hopefully won't hurt us too much in the long run. Big tackle after the kick as well. Muhammad has that covered. Returns. Tries to get a bit of interest. But only finds it to the fullback who struggles. And he puts in a little chip up over the top. And Mayo deals with it well. We've got numbers back there. And we should be safe now to launch some territory here. So technically, the first half is complete. It's 12-7. And we have a last-ditch chance here. Oh, Bondicio. He's done something special there. But the whistle is gone. Well, advantage has popped up. Now the whistle's gone. Hands in the ruck. And this could be a real kick in the guts here. If they get the shot, a goal right before halftime, it's gone wide. It has gone wide. And Muhammad saves the day for us at the back. That is halftime. Second half quickly underway. 12-7 the score. When do we see some more action? We are holding on to a very, very slender lead at the moment. So we've got a scrum feed going on here for the Wasps. They just trail by 5 points and they're in the... What a mistake by their fly half there. He spilt that absolute coal. And now it is the Invaders with a scrum. All advantage for a loose bind as well. So now we play with advantage on the 22. A real chance to attack. Away to Lior, who's kicked. Leo, what are you doing? What advantage? It's really not bad, though. If we could have played our advantage or line out, but we're going to go back. Yes, we're going back for what could be a crucial 3 points here. Bondesio! Bondesio, yes! He's got that point of difference. It's 15-7. And the Invaders lead the Wasps. Now, we've got that over 7 point buffer, which is exactly what we need. Terrible pass. Bonesio makes good of, though. He drags away one defender. And we start again. 46 minutes gone on the clock now. And we have an 8 point lead. And we've got a good breakaway here. O'Neill Brown. If there's one man that could have sparked that into something special, was him. Bonesio with a lot of space. There's Akers back there for Bondesio, who's kicked it clear and given us a great attacking chance on defence. Bruno, they'll clear it away here. Minimalu has murdered a man. That was a huge hit. We're winning, though. We are winning the kicking duels at the moment because we kicked that inside our own half, and now we have the line out, about 10-metre line of theirs. 47 gone. It's man on, man on. O'Neill Brown, come on. You can't do that against the hooker. You've got to beat the man, O'Neill Brown. Again, width. I love this width because we got it to Mayo. And Mayo says, oh, no. That was a try. Just wanting to be scored. Mayo did so well. And the overlapping behind the defense didn't work. And now they'll clear their lines. Another good kick, finding it away from Muhammad, who will return. That's nice from Muhammad. Getting good roll on. We're back to a game of drive back. Wake up, Muhammad. Oh, and Muhammad, it's in your head. What are you doing? Oh, Muhammad, that is terrible. Oh, Muhammad, he's really lost out there. Big time, we've lost out. Oh, here's something. It's a penalty for an offside against the Wasps. Now, this is, where are we? Midway, 22. To 10 metre line. We have advantage. Minimalu, such a strong run of the ball. Here is Bondesio. Oh, a little attacking chip over the top. It's pulled in for Muhammad. Oh, Muhammad's knocked it on. Begging to be scored a try. Muhammad spills it. But we go back to the advantage offside. Here is Bondesio. Created it. A chance for three more. Oh, it's gone wide by a whisker. And Pereira puts it down in the end goal. 22 dropout to the Wasps. We are, wow, that that was really short. I mean, there's short line, short 22s and there's short 22s. And he has to go over the line, though. Here's the room. Here's a chance. Muhammad O'Neill Brown. Oh, he just about finds a way on the outside. Hanano. Well, he's got no one close by here. Hanano. Big pass from Hanano. Round the corner. Oh, this is brilliant from the Invaders. The clock says 60 minutes. A try here would be a difference maker. O'Neill Brown puts a little grubber through, forces a man into touch. Good covering defense, chasing the ball. Line out. Lost. Dreadful kick, though. That was smashing tackle. It's almost given us a counter-attacking chance here. Carter, we've got advantage. Hands in the ruck. It's our ball. Was it our hands in the ruck or theirs? Oh, it was ours. That's a real shame. They clear it away again. And we've missed out on more points. 61 minutes gone, almost 62. We lead by 8 still. Slender margin. And the Wasps are looking to... Oh, knock on. Hello. And a turnover as well. Knock on advantage. Scrum advantage. Call it what you like. We have the ball. 42 or so metres out. Wow, Both has been absolutely smashed there. Come on, team. What have you got? Hanano. Well, one-on-one out wide here for O'Neill Brown. That's what he can do. Just about did something. We're going to go back for the scrum. So, good attacking football here from the Invaders. So, we have a line-out feed here for the Galway Wasps. It's thrown over the back, which is great for us because Minimalu's got it. Now, we're joining the game here because we only have about 3 and a bit minutes left on the clock. We have the ball. Lior, he's put a little nothing kick there. Dribbles, though. Nicely, and wow, that is great chasing from the Invaders. The score is 15-7. With only 3 minutes to go, surely we've secured this. As they come wide, the Wasps are making room in behind. Chase him. Make the tackle, Mayo. No, he hasn't. Oh, he's dropped it. Muhammad with a great tackle. Shuts him down as 15-7. There's 2 and a bit minutes to go. Not long. My eyes are firmly on the clock. Here it is. Chipped ahead. Clock ticks over, just about 78 minutes now. There was a, what was that? Was that a kick? That was a dreadful kick. I'm watching the clock more than I'm watching what's going on. The Wasps are waking a huge amount of time-wasting plays here. But they've got the overlap out wide once again, but it's only a prop. Well, Carter's turned that over. What a great play from Carter. 2 minutes to go. Mayo, quick hands wide. And it's Jorkovic. We haven't hardly said his name at all. The forwards have done the hard words here. Hard work. Here's Mayo, wide, and Carter does well to secure possession. A minute and a half to go on the clock. We lead by eight. That means surely they can't score twice now. Wide ball. Mayo slides through. The pass is all right. Lior actually catches it. Has that been knocked on? It has. It's advantage to the Wasps this time. Man, Mayo has been brilliant at breaking the line. This is passing and offloading. Not quite up to it. That's something we need to look at training, though. Oh, no. Here's a good run here for that bloody open sider who carved us up earlier. That's Mirandu. Just about does it again. Got to watch that. A minute to go. Here come Wasps. They're doing well. Dobry. Quick recycle ball. And they keep the passes close by. And still goes Pereira. They're going to score. Oh, it's Mirandu again. It's that open sider. He scored right on 80 minutes. Can you believe it? The penalty goal has... Is that missed? No, it's gone over. The penalty goal wins us a game. Oh, Brock Bondesio, you hero. You are a legend of the club. And we love you here at the Invaders. 15-14, first win of the season. But we need to stop conceding so late on in the game. I mean, if we hadn't got that penalty goal, we would have lost with seconds remaining. That would have killed me. Absolutely killed me. Here's some amazing highlights. Muhammad was brilliant. Carter was brilliant as well. O'Neill Brown was good. Brock Bondesio was even better. Muhammad scored one of our two tries. I think we played magnificently today. Our kick chasing, exceptional. The kicking duels, we won a few, we lost a few. But overall, Mirandu, I have no qualms about him being man of the match because he scored both of their tries. This is a nice little highlights package. O'Neill Brown really showing his speed here to go in for our second try and crucial try as well. We played very, very nicely. Let's have a look at the stats here. What have we got to show? 15-14. It shouldn't have been that close. It never should have been anywhere near that close. Score 15-14. Possession almost inseparable there. Territory fell 44-56. They did have a little bit of an advantage there. Tackle count almost dead even. We missed 19 to their 13. Two tries apiece, but look at that. 16 handing errors by Wasps, only 7 by the Invaders. Both sides making a couple of offloads. Attacking rucks, almost dead even. We got 2 more turnovers. We did miss our penalty. They missed 3 throughout the game as well. Crucial ones too. We missed a conversion. But overall, I think Bondesio was pretty good throughout the game. We conceded a lot of penalties, which is a bit of a concern against a team that's good kicker in their side as well. Interesting time down here. This is what I always find we're very low on, but 55 seconds in their red zone. 22 is, which I presume that's counted as, to a minute 54. They spent over twice as long in our red zone as we did in theirs, yet we won. It should have been 15-7, let's be honest, but they scored that good try at the end. Credit to them. But overall, I think, you know, we need to improve this. We get chances, we convert them, which is great. But we need to get more chances, obviously. Get more time in the area. Our kicking is good. We just need, some little tweaks. I think we're really close still. I didn't change really much before this matchup. But just keeping that lead out and above 7 points is crucial going into the final end of things. We stole 2 of their lineouts, which is spectacular. And we lost 2 of our scrums on tight heads, which is a shame. Set piece stats, I'm interested to see how our new man Zengidi went. Defensive lineouts takes, so he stole. Zengidi stole one of their lineouts and Quazim stole one as well. That is great. And they were both clean takes as well, so good to see that. Overall, the stats tell 1,000 stories. Moody Moody Valu, He's the number 8. He shouldn't really be jumping in the line-out anyway. But overall, I think that's good. Our line-out jumpers are doing their job, and that's all that matters. So overall, we won our own ball. I think we lost 2 line-outs. We played pretty well. But most importantly than all, we get the W. Win, win, win. That is the Invaders. Let's see what that does to the table now. Only the win. No bonus points here today for us. But there will be one for the Wasps for losing within 7. They shouldn't have. But they did. Credit to them, they got a point. Okay, so our first win of the season, and it sees the Invaders now go 2 games, 1 win, 1 loss, and we have a bonus point as well from round 1, so we have a 5-point total for our matches so far this season. Points for and against, very, very tight there, 36-4, 41 against, would look to improve that, hopefully, in the coming weeks. But the team we beat straight across here, Galway Wasps, they are 25th now. 2 losses for that team, but they've got 3 bonus points, which is amazing. They've obviously gone on for scoring 4 tries and losing within 7 twice. They didn't score 4 tries against us, which is testament to our defence, I think, surely. But we look good. We're sitting, mid-table? There's about 30-something teams. Who's the last? 32nd? So we're sitting nicely in the middle. A close loss and a close win. It's entertaining at least. That's definitely the way it goes. We've done well to get our first win, and we have joined the points table with a W, which is what I like to see. Business well and truly picks up heading into round 3 though, because we are still at home, which is great, but we're up against the Edinburgh Blues. Now, this is going to be tough. This is going to be tough. Like you guys have said in the comments as well, the Edinburgh Blues, let's take a bit of a look here. Yeah. Top team in our division, and unfortunately they are in our little group as well, which means I think we're going to play them a couple of times. I think unfortunately the best team in the league so far. It'll be better if we're in this group over here, wouldn't it? They're 22nd, 23rd, 25th and 27th. That would have been a lot better if we could have played those guys a couple of times. But hey, you got to play what's in front of you. At the moment we're looking all right. Amazingly, all of our group here has a win on the board after 2 games, and looking at the others, only one other group can say that, which is this one here, can say that. So that's interesting, very interesting stuff. From Conference 2, we are looking all right. Sitting mid-table, Hamilton Capitals, I think, might be a pretty tough game as well when we play them again. We did only just lose them in our last match, so I'm out for revenge against those guys, because I think we should have beaten them. And look how well they're doing now, up to 6th. They put the pain on someone in their second match, that's for sure. But the Invaders, I think, are better than 18th, to be honest with you. The team is looking better and better, and we need to, do some hard work here against some of these boys. This is going to be interesting. Going to be a great season. Hope you join me throughout it as well. After 2 rounds, we're sitting pretty with a win and a loss, 5 points on the board. But a toughie against the Edinburgh Blues in round number 3. Aside from that, it's fair to say not much has happened in the Invaders over the last week. Amazingly, a few scouting jobs going on with the youth, which I'll touch you guys up on possibly next week or the week after. Not doing too much early on because finances are a little bit tight at the moment, so I don't want to overdo things. I've got the whole season to look out for these guys, so slowly but surely I'll get through them. I have a couple of key guys I'm looking at first. Other than that, it is pretty slow going at the club at the moment. Slight tweaks to our strategy and things like that, but keep posted on how we're going. If you've joined up in the game and you're in my division, or you'll be up against me soon, do leave me a comment in the comment section below and have a chat about the game and what you all think about it. If you haven't joined up, what the hell are you doing? Get to globalrugbymanager.com, download your client, and get your team today. You've got to do it. It's a great little game. As always, thanks to the guys at GRM for allowing me to do these videos. A superly fun game to play. Super tense games as well. It's always fun to watch the matches, and I'll be back again for round 3 very, very soon. 1 game a week. It's going quite nicely at the moment. Hope your team's doing fantastically as well. But until next time, thanks for tuning in and watching, and until we meet again, take care.